Here comes the push towards the B site. Scream's going to make contact here from back behind the big box. EC1S is there as well with a bit of paranoia support. The wall's going to come down as the Boombot tunnels towards the back side of site. Still no spike plant coming in here as they're trying to get control, but there's Scream doing Scream things. He's brought it down to one. It'll be Xiao who sneaks through that smoke over towards the A connector. Scream, you know he wants the ace. He's going to play the 50-50. Not going to get it right. The wall's going to go up. The round is very much fish 1-2-3s.
I'm going to assume that that's going to be in hell as it'll be the Omen player that's back there. Eccles, still a couple more seconds left. There's not a whole lot of time to get that spike down, and he takes out the carrier. There's not enough time. Angel's mowing him down, and it's the first map win for Party Parrots. Delay over towards that B site, but it'll actually call Angel to pull over, and a guess, a read on the orbital strike. They'll start to funnel in through the cage, and it's just a spray down from Dinkshade, but the clip starts to fall empty. Angel from above will find two, and it's starting to fall apart here for Fish 1-2-3. It'll be the 3v1 for Scream as he's the last member standing, spike behind enemy lines, and Party Parrots looks like they will keep their dream alive with 12-9.
It was something I meant to mention. They still had the orbital strike. So there was still something to fall back on here. Scream will do at least a little damage. Yeah, you don't want to see this happen. With the scoreline this close, you can't afford to be losing that many bodies at the end of a round you've already won. There was a counter wall as well coming in from the attack over towards mid. So that gives additional time for these guys to get into position without having to worry about that cross shot coming through. Inside the site, only one working out nicely. But as I say that, they start to pile up. It's Scream finding two. Make it three on the round. Just oh so good from those back stairs in the 1v1 against Angel. It's a ninth round for Fish 1-2-3, and that's not what you wanted to see if you're a Party Parrots fan.
It's the Hunter's Fury that is causing really a difficult push forward, as now they will finally commit trying to close that door, but it might be broken before it is even done being closed. Artist, the last one standing, they're looking for the knife. Scream was the one hunting down, blade in hand, and it's Sulcus. Fish 1-2-3 will be the winners of the best of three.
The Aladrone as well. The orb coming in to try and slow things down. They're going to continue to push out because of that dart in David P's belly. He's got a move. I love the movement coming out from Hip to try to dodge the shots, but Petitech is there and he's just oh too quick. It'll come down to now three on NIP as G2 continue to play defense, but they're losing control of the site. Now Mixwell has showed up with that operator. Mixwell's going to find three on the round. A nice shot to close things out as he drives one through the skull of Firoth. Three straight rounds for G2 since they've been able to afford that big buy in round number five. Does he hold this and find that first shot though? Recon dart goes down, not gonna connect. The smoke comes in. There's the ult being popped as well. Mixwell's gonna move back as far as possible, but in that time they lose pit in the site. Mixwell through the smoke, able to find one more. That's two on the round for Mixwell as the op player for G2. The knives come out on the ult, but can't make it work. Artist was only able to get one before being taken out of play. Paranoia coming in from Potty Tech, and that will be the way the round goes towards G2. All tied up at four apiece. Looked promising in the start for NIP, but it falls apart after Mixwell hits some raunchy shots. First one through the cyber cage, second through the smoke with the tracking dart.
As he thinks enough time has passed, but it's the execute for G2. Only person on the site is Rhyme, and he's got a lot of members for G2 starting to funnel in. The headshots, good one after the other. Still one more on the site. Uses the camera. Shot's not going to connect, though, as Pith will be the one that comes out on top. But it's down to the 2v2. An expensive round now for G2, but it is up to Nip to focus on the retake.
Players in this A site, though, being taken out left and right. Lucker using the wall again, this time going up top with the Sheriff. It doesn't work out as well as it has in times with the AWP. But there's Rhyme hitting one shot, make it two. Rhyme's been so good. They're going to send him into the site as well, and it's now down to one. It's David P on the other side of the generator as the spike gets secured. Hit. Does he get the timing of the shot right? No. David P narrowly wins the round there for G2, and they continue in similar form. This could very likely be our final, so consider this a small taste of what you might see later on in the tournament.
Specifically Sunday, for those of you wondering. Sunday will be the grand final day. David P, come on! David P with three! Lucker able to take him down finally, but David P just always, somehow on this map, has really shown us his magic.
again, the B site is actually kind of empty right now. That's a really passive B site defense with three players up in heaven, so they're just going to go right onto the site. Artist times this one perfectly, and G2 just obliterated that B side defense play from NIP. They played too passively, gave up too much control to G2, and they said, oh, you're going to give us that site? Well, we'll happily take it. Thank you. You can see they're kind of leaning in that direction. There's the bomb buddy to lead them in. Oh, the Leer comes out, but no, it gives away his position. As a result, it doesn't actually help. So now it's on the Cypher, who's over in this B site. He's trying to use the one way. Rhyme goes for the cam shot, and at that point, taken out. It's all up to Kriya, and there's a wall down in his path. It's looking like G2 is going to take things here 2-1 over NIP and guarantee their pick in the semifinals on Sunday. And that's exactly what's going to, or on Saturday, excuse me, tomorrow. And that's exactly what's going to happen. Great game coming out from G2.